What can you tell us, if there's anything that fans have to look forward to the rest of the season?
A lot.
Yeah, well, most of the questions that were being raised about motivations for why these guys were kidnapped, why Chandler was, they tried to kill him on his plane, you know, what is this warble that Valerie hears on the plane? All these questions have been sort of subsumed by the action of just getting our guys back. So there's a whole new stuff, story to tell in the back half of the season.
So we're going to finally get some answers.
We'll get some answers, yeah, mm-hmm. And more questions. Mm-hmm.
Yeah. And then you've had a chance. They're off the ship a little much more this season. They're in Japan on the island. And you see them having grown from being the crew that all they were focused on was finding the cure, and they found it. And now it's their opportunity to stretch out. So has it been fun watching the characters grow from, you know, just hunting the cure, getting the cure, and now they, you know, got it, and now it's the next steps.
Yeah, I'll say. I mean, I think it's sort of like if we were in this building at nighttime and the power went out. We would wonder, is it just this building, or is it across the street too? Mm-hmm. That was the first season. Our lights went out. We didn't know what the rest of the world looked like, and we just had to deal with each other. Second season, we got this taste of America, and then third season, we're seeing what the world has to offer. So we love exploring and expanding the storytelling and bringing in fresh characters and seeing how the story goes.
Yeah. And how was that joining this crew? Because it's got to be a pretty tight crew. They shoot on the ship. Yeah. There's tight quarters, and here you come. And how has it been joining the cast?
Well, the cast is incredible. The crew is the finest crew I've ever worked with. I think it's absolutely stunning what they do in 9 days. I mean, it's a blockbuster, you know, huge blockbuster movie each week that this show produces, and it's an honor to join them. I had a lot of catching up to do in terms of research and training and all that to get to the level that the whole cast was already at. But thankfully, everyone was so generous and everyone was helping me, and even when I would ask stupid questions, they would indulge them. And
lots of action, so I imagine that can be challenging, some of the stuff that you are shooting.
Yeah, I've done a lot of stunts before and action, so that helped me, but I've never had to do this much of with the arms, the weapons, and all that has been very new for me. But thankfully, I mean, we're working with real SEALs, Harry Humphreys and his crew, and they're actual men that did this, and they are the ones that are helping us look great, and we listen to them.
Yeah, that must be very satisfying, because I've heard that they're very happy with how, you know, the Navy's portrayed and the military, and that you guys keep the codes or, you know, their ethics, and all of them have been very happy with that.
Yeah, the Navy are, you know, they let us do our thing. We tell our stories on our own, but they are partners with us in the sense that they respect what we're doing, and they're mm-hmm. able to give us access to stuff that we wouldn't have access to otherwise, yeah. because they like how we're portraying their codes, their culture, mm-hmm. their
yeah, and I think
values.
it's a great part of the story too. It's nice to see that. It really adds to the storyline.
Oh, thank you. Yeah.